Is this ignition coil good or bad? To make sure you get a good one, you just have to buy a new one, but it may be expensive. The best option is still to be able to test it, right? Hi everyone, so on my car, I first had a lack of power and some abnormal engine vibrations. Then the check engine light came on. So the first thing to do in these cases is to read the trouble codes with a OBD scanner. I plugged the scanner into the OBD2 port, and I turned the key to the accessory position, and the trouble code read is PO304, which corresponds to misfires detected on cylinder number 4. So there is no need to look any further, it corresponds well to the symptoms. With a cylinder that does not work, you lose some power, and it also makes engine vibrations. On cars which have a lot of electronics, the first thing to test is to make sure the battery is charging well. Yes, because with a bad charging circuit, it is possible to have some trouble codes that have nothing to do with the issue. I start the car and plug my voltmeter into the battery. (14.5 volts) It's good. So here I have a bar graph, and it does not fluctuate. It means that the voltage is quite stable. I have no problem with the charging circuit, so the issue lies elsewhere. Now the first possible cause of misfires, but also the easiest to test, is the ignition system. So I'm going to test the ignition system of the cylinder number 4, and on this car, the cylinder number 4 is here. And so I will start by testing the ignition coil. I unplug the connector that powers the coil, and I can unplug the connector from the fuel injector as well. And the coil is held by a single size 6 screw. Done, here is the screw, and I pull. There it is. The screw comes in the hole there. So here is the ignition coil, sometimes called pencil coils, simply because it has the shape of a pencil. Inside there is a transformer which allows to supply the high voltage necessary for the formation of the spark at the spark plug. The primary of the transformer is located here. The ignition pulses arrive at a low voltage 12 volts with high current. And on the other side there is the secondary of the transformer, where the spark plug is connected. And on this side, the current is much lower, but the voltage is high enough to create spark at the spark plug. The ground connection is made by the screw on the engine. And to test this coil, I use an ignition coil tester. If you are interested, I put a link below in the description of the video. So on that side, it's shaped like the top of the spark plug. I plug it directly into the ignition coil like that. And the wire on the other side should be connected to the car frame. I will be able to observe the sparks here in this window. Of course, the engine must be running with the coil connected to the primary. I connect the ground here, and I can adjust the length of the spark by turning at the ground connector. The standard spark length for ignition coils is approximately 2 centimeters. So yes, it is much longer than the spark from a spark plug, but it is because the gas pressure is much higher in the cylinder than in the tester. I'll start with a spark length of 1 centimeter. Now I connect the ignition coil normally to its wire. So the fuel injector connector is plugged in, but you can leave it unplugged. In fact, it avoids injecting gasoline into the cylinder, which will not work anyway. I start the engine. And I see sparks. So I turn off the light, you will see better. Here I have sparks of a 1 centimeter length. So my ignition coil is working, but I will still test with a length of sparks of 2 centimeters. So at 2 centimeters I still have sparks, but a little less. I must surely be at the limit. The instructions for the tool indicate that if there is no spark, it means that the coil does not work, but if the spark is orange or even red, making a lot of zigzags, well, that's not good either. The important thing is that the spark is relatively straight and blue. My ignition coil is therefore good. But what is the issue with my car? Well, since the ignition coil is working correctly, now I'll test the spark plug. I remove it. Here it is. It is not in good condition, and it smells like gasoline. I clean it before testing it. And now I'm going to test this spark plug with a spark plug tester. So I put a new spark plug on the right and the one I have just removed on the left. I also put a link to the spark plug tester at the bottom in the description. Well, it's not complicated. The spark plug I have just removed doesn't work at all. So the issue is found and I just have to put a new spark plug. I add a little copper grease on the thread before assembly. I start by tightening by hand. Then I tighten with the correct torque. On this car it is 34 newton meters. Here I have refitted the ignition coil over the spark plug, and I reconnect the two connectors. And now I just have to test. So it no longer vibrates, and there isn't any trouble code after having cleared it. And here it is, this video is now complete. I hope it saves you from unnecessary and costly coil replacements. If you liked it, don't hesitate to share it, give a thumbs up or add a comment, or consider subscribe to the channel. And see you soon on Enjoy Wheels.